Throughout history, human beings have thought that the universe would exist forever. This error formed the backbone of materialist Greek philosophies and of the polytheist religions of Sumeria and Egypt. The most important reason for this superstition is that many people are unaware of the truths revealed by the divine religions, or else choose to ignore them. In earlier times, low levels of science and technology may well have influenced the way that people formed such a misconception. In the present day, however, it has been scientifically established that the universe had a beginning and will inevitably come to an end sometime in the future. That great truth was openly revealed in the Quran, which was sent down some 1,400 years ago. The universe will one day definitely come to an end. In other words, doomsday will inevitably come. There is no question about it. And the hour is coming without any doubt. We did not create the heavens and earth and everything between them except with truth. The hour is certainly coming. The perfect order that has functioned perfectly for billions of years is the work of the Lord, who created everything. And this order will come to a glorious end at His command at a time that He has determined. The entire universe and everything in it, animate or inanimate, from the largest to the very smallest, will be destroyed. Along with the announcement of the end of the world, the Quran contains a detailed description of the stages of that event. When the heavens are rent asunder, when the sea is set on fire, when the mountains are ripped up and scattered, when the sun is extinguished. The end of the world will be a catastrophe such as the world has never experienced before. It is clear from some verses of the Quran that the inevitable end of the world has excited interest in every period of history. People sought to learn the time of doomsday from the Prophet Muhammad. They will ask you about the hour. When is it due? The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was commanded to answer this question in this way. Knowledge of it rests with my Lord alone. Together with keeping the time of doomsday a secret from man, God revealed to the Prophet Muhammad certain events and portents that would indicate the time was approaching. This film you are watching will relate some of the main portents revealed by God's messenger that doomsday is approaching. Near the establishment of the hour, there will be much al-harj, and al-harj means killing. The last hour will not come unless there is much bloodshed. There has been conflict between people all through history. Until the 20th century, however, these conflicts were always regional, small-scale affairs. The wars that involved the whole of mankind erupted in the 20th century. Millions of people lost their lives during the First and Second World Wars. As many people again were left homeless, crippled, or deprived of their loved ones. The 20th century opened with wars and saw increasingly savage ones as time passed. The Korean War, the Vietnam War, the Arab-Israeli conflict, Iran-Iraq, and the Gulf War. Bosnia, Palestine, Chechnya, Afghanistan, Kashmir. The repercussions of war reached ever greater dimensions as modern military technology advanced. The use of nuclear, biological, and chemical weapons led to terrible mass slaughter. It has also been established that violent and terrorist movements increased rapidly in the 20th century. Tens of thousands of people have been killed or crippled as a result of the actions of organizations that have emerged with ideological agenda and claims of racial discrimination. This inhuman picture, which reached a peak during the last century, is one of the major pieces of evidence that we are in the age described in the Hadith and that doomsday is at hand. Great cities will be ruined, and it will be as if they had not existed the day before. In the previous section, we saw how the military technology developed in the 20th century had wreaked terrible harm on mankind. The very worst effects of that were seen in the big cities. Nuclear weapons. Bombs with terrible destructive power, laser-guided missiles, and similar weapons began to be used in warfare in the recent past. These dreadful weapons have wreaked destruction on major settlements, the likes of which has never been seen before. The use of the atomic bomb wiped two Japanese cities off the face of the map. European capitals were razed to the ground as a result of constant bombing. history has witnessed unmatched destruction in the countless wars of the 20th century. The destruction wreaked on crowded population centers has not come from human hands alone. Some major cities have been obliterated by natural disasters. Earthquakes, hurricanes, and whirlwinds have caused enormous damage in many settled areas all over the world. At this point, researchers reveal a most astonishing truth. Our age has witnessed an unbelievable rise in the scale and number of natural disasters. When all the natural disasters recorded all through history are examined, their size and scale are vastly different to those of the 20th century. This is another proof that the doomsday pointed to in the Hadith is at hand. The last day will not be established until earthquakes will be very frequent. In the previous section, we looked at the disasters that have struck big cities and saw how such disasters, both man-made in the form of war and natural disasters, have destroyed whole cities. When we examine these natural disasters a little more closely, another portent of doom emerges before our eyes. That is the earthquake so frequently stressed in the Hadith. According to American National Earthquake Information Center figures, there have been 20,832 earthquakes on Earth in 1999 alone, during which tens of thousands of people have lost their lives. The number and intensity of earthquakes is increasing. Once more demonstrating the truth of the news of the end times revealed in the Hadith. poor will grow in number. Gains will be shared out only among the rich, with no benefit to the poor. As the last day draws near, these hadiths revealing that poverty and high costs of living will assume much greater dimensions are rapidly coming true in the present day. Many people in Africa, Asia, South America, and Eastern Europe are staring hunger in the face. Researchers into this subject reveal that one quarter of the world's population, or some 1.5 billion people, live under conditions of inconceivable misery and poverty. According to the figures, for the year 2000, 826 million people in the world are undernourished. In other words, one out of every six people is starving. But why? Is it because there are not enough resources? No. The unfair and unjust distribution of capital among the people of the world means that only a very few people are able to benefit from the world's resources, while hundreds of millions of others are condemned to hunger, poverty, and misery. Furthermore, the scale of this inequality has been on the rise since the beginning of the 20th century. One of the most important reasons for this tragic picture is that people have turned as far away as possible from listening to the dictates of their consciences and all forms of human and ethical values. There will be prevalence of open, illegal sexual intercourse. The hour will come when adultery becomes widespread. Men will imitate women, and women will imitate men. The most important element that binds societies together and regulates human relations at the ideal levels is moral values. In our day, however, these moral values that keep societies functioning are under enormous threat. Homosexuality, prostitution, premarital and extramarital sex, sexual crimes, pornography, sexual assault, and the increase of sex-related illnesses are some important indications of the collapse of moral values. The rapid rise and spread of homosexuality is particularly noteworthy. Homosexuals these days are able to organize on a world scale, establish associations and political parties, even officially marry in some countries, and wage war on religious beliefs by opposing sacred beliefs. As we have seen, homosexuality has today reached its most widespread and highest levels in the 14 centuries between the time of God's messenger and the present. Hadiths reveal that the acceptance of homosexuality as such a normal way of living is another indication of the imminent approach of the last day. People will indulge in homosexuality and lesbianism. There will come a time upon the Ummah when people will recite the Quran, but it will not go further than their throats, into their hearts. There will come a time for my people when the mosques will be full of people, but they will be empty of right guidance. One of the most important portents of the end times is the all but complete abandonment of the religion of God and the morality of the Quran. The end of times is when the verses of the Quran will be ignored. False rules will be brought in God's name. There will be sectarianism in religion. Destiny will be denied. Worship will be carried out purely for show, and religion will be used as a means to private ends. These signs were revealed by our Prophet 1,400 years ago. The hour will come when people believe in the stars and reject El Qadar, the divine decree of destiny. There will come a time for my people when there will remain nothing of the Quran except its outward form, and nothing of Islam except its name. And they will call themselves by this name, even though they are the people furthest from it. Divorces will be a daily occurrence. There will be an abundance of illegitimate children. This move away from the superior moral values such as justice, peace, love, affection, chastity, honor, and protecting the rights of others which religion brings with it, naturally also brings with it social collapse. This process of social collapse reveals itself in a number of different ways. The collapse of the family, divorce, children born out of wedlock, the disappearance of business and commercial ethics, corruption, fraud, stress, worry, discontentment, and a rapid rise in alcohol and drug dependency. People who fall into a spiritual emptiness for these reasons are thus pulled down dark paths. Those who are unable to find the way out commit an even greater abomination and take their own lives. The fact that all these indicators have increased enormously over the last century is one of the signs that we are living in the end times and that doomsday is at hand. Our prophet went into considerable detail regarding the disintegration of the social structure that will be experienced in the run-up to the last day. These details include: the hour will not be established until murders will increase. The time will be years of confusion. People will believe a liar and disbelieve one who tells the truth. People will distrust one who is trustworthy and trust one who is treacherous. Verily, in the presence of the last hour, there would be false testimony and concealing evidence. Deceit and cheating will be common. Bribes will be called gifts and will be considered lawful. Historical sources show that when the Quran was revealed, Arab society did not have the technology to enable them to carry out any investigations of nature or the universe. This means that there is an incomparable difference between the level of science and technology at the time when the Prophet Muhammad lived and that of our own time. Despite this, the hadiths of our Prophet have revealed a great many technological advances that will be made in the end times. Let us now have a look at these technological advances. At that time, lifespans will grow longer. The average life expectancy is now much greater than it has ever been in the 1,400 years since our Prophet gave these tidings. There is even a great difference in this regard between the beginning and the end of the 20th century. The development of health services due to the advance of medical technology have made such a gain possible. In addition, development in genetic science and the rapidly advancing Human Genome Project are about to begin a totally new era in the field of health. These advances are on such a scale that the people who lived in earlier times could never even have conceived of them. The hour will not be established till the people compete with one another in constructing high buildings. If we look at the history of architecture and engineering, we see that multi-storied buildings began to be constructed towards the end of the 19th century. Technological progress, the spread of steel and the use of electric lifts have accelerated the building of skyscrapers. What the Hadith says has come true. People would compete in the construction of tall buildings, and nations would enter into rivalry with one another to see who could build the tallest skyscrapers. The last day will not be established until time will pass quickly. Great distances will be traversed in short spans of time. In our time, supersonic aircraft, trains, and other advanced vehicles can travel in a few hours the distance it used to take months to cross, and they can do it more easily, comfortably, and safely. The sign in the hadiths has come true in this way. The statement that time will pass quickly in the first hadith can be looked at in this light. It is clear that God's messenger said that at the end times, things would be completed in a much shorter time compared to other periods. Indeed, the advance of science makes it possible for all jobs to be done in a much shorter time, and for much better results to be achieved. Another similar hadith points in that same direction. The last hour will not come before time contracts, a year being like a month like a week like a day like an hour, and an hour like the kindling of a fire. Hundreds of years ago, for instance, communication between continents would take weeks, whereas now it is a matter of seconds with the internet and satellites equipped with modern communications technology. Today, millions of books can be published in the time it took a few centuries ago to write one single book. Daily things such as cleaning, cooking, and childcare no longer take a long time with the help of technological wonders. In short, when we look at today's technology, we see all the developments set out in the hadiths of our Prophet. The last day will not come until a person's own voice speaks to him. One of our Prophet's hadiths points to the development of communications technology in these terms. For a person to hear his own voice, first it has to be recorded and then listened to. Voice recording and reproduction technology are products of the 20th century. Other hadiths indicating the development in communications technology that will be experienced in the approach of the last day read, "A voice will call him by name, and even people in the east and west will hear it." This voice will spread over the entire world, and every nation will hear it in their own language. A voice from the sky that everyone will hear in his own language. These hadiths mention a voice that will be heard throughout the whole world in everyone's own language. Evidently, this refers to radio, television, and other such methods of communication. It is a miracle that 1,400 years ago, the Prophet referred to a development that was unimaginable even 100 years ago. So far in this film, we have been looking at portents of doomsday in the light of the hadiths handed down to us by the Prophet Muhammad. And we have seen that indeed the period we are living in is that indicated as the end times, just before the last day. However, the hadiths are not the only statements to contain clues about the last day. A great many verses in the Quran also deal with the subject. A large part of these verses describe the tumultuous incidents that will accompany doomsday, and some are thought to refer to the portents as the last day approaches. One of these is to be found in Surah Qamar. Qamar is the name of the 54th Surah in the Quran. That means moon in English. The first verse of this Surah is considered to contain a most important message on the subject of the end times. The hour has drawn near and the moon has split. The word split used in this verse is the Arabic shakka, which in Arabic has various meanings. In some commentaries on the Quran, the meaning split is preferred. But shakka in Arabic can also mean plowing or digging the earth. One of the verses in which this verb is used reads, "We pour down plentiful water, then split the earth into furrows. Then we make grain grow in it, and grapes and herbs and olives and dates." The meaning of shakka here is not to split, it means to plow the earth. If we went back to the year 1969, we would see one of the greatest wonders of the Quran. The experiments carried out on the surface of the moon on July 20, 1969 may be hinting at the fulfillment of news given 1,400 years ago in the Surah Qamar. On that date, American astronauts set foot on the moon. Digging at the lunar soil, they carried out scientific experiments and collected samples of stones and soil. It is surely very interesting that these developments are in complete agreement with the statements in the verse. In this film, we have examined many social developments that occurred in the 20th century and are still being experienced today. The majority of these are developments that were revealed by the Prophet Muhammad some 1,400 years ago. The Prophet used the expression end times to refer to the time when these would be experienced, and said that some of these events were a sign that last hour was near. We have also witnessed how just about all these portents have now come about. It must not be forgotten that every portent that comes about shows that the last hour has drawn a little closer, and reminds us of the importance of immediately returning to the morality of the Quran. Most people in our time never consider these matters, or decline to talk about them. Even talking about natural disasters or watching a film about death or disaster can be unbearable for them. What they are trying to do is to escape the fear that the idea of doomsday inspires. However, it is an inescapable fact that doomsday will happen. God reveals that doomsday is near in another verse. And the hour is coming without any doubt. The signs set out in the hadiths and verses are coming about one after the other at the present time. Developments the like of which have never been seen before are coming about right in the age we are living in. People must not ignore these divine portents, but must make the best possible use of them. The signs of the end times are a great warning and a reminder to them. God's promises are a certain truth. No one can change His promises or prevent their fulfillment. As in every matter, so here the best and most beautiful last words come from the Quran. Say, "Praise be to God. He will show you His signs, and you will recognize them."